Insulin, it's a requirement.
As a diabetic, my body can't produce insulin. It's a pretty expensive disease to have. With diabetes, you don't really get to take a day off. You really need to have a handle on your disease. It's always there.
We're harnessing recent advances in engineering biology or in synthetic biology to enable us to produce natural products, hormones, insulin, in a way that we can produce them faster, better, cheaper, more effectively than what's traditionally done. So the thing about insulin is it's actually two molecules. The two pieces are connected by a chain, and then that chain is eventually cut off and the two pieces are together. What we've done that's truly novel here is we've taken one of our design proteins and we've used that protein sort of as a metal clamp, a molecular clamp that brings these two pieces together, pre-organizes them in the right orientation, thereby encouraging them to assemble appropriately. At the end of the day, we have the same insulin that your body would make. We've been working on this system now for quite some time in the laboratory, and we've got it going really well. The science works. To move forward, we now need to scale things up. We need to get out of a small laboratory in the Princeton Chemistry Department, and we need to be able to produce the stuff in larger quantities. And ultimately, we need to be able to do the kind of quality control measurements that are essential to bring any drug to market. It's our goal to make insulin more available at more accessible prices to more people whose lives depend upon it.
Basic research is so important to improve our lives, not just now, but in 10, 15, 20 years.